Hello and welcome to NewsClick. If you're watching us this and you see Jaideep sir and me and Leslie and you don't see Siddhant, then you know this is not a 420 grams. The crazy thing is that the three of us were last on a show when we were doing our own award show, if you remember. We were doing our own greatest of all time in Olympics for India. And obviously the government has taken a cue from us a little bit, and they also do their annual awards, the National Sports Awards. This year's National Sports Awards have been at the focal point of a lot of debate, because in a year that had seen very little sport action, we have the maximum number of Arjuna awardees ever. We have the maximum number of people getting sports awards across all the categories ever. And a few names have also like caused a little bit of consternation among a lot of sports fans, sports persons themselves, and the omission of some names has also been a huge problem. So there's, without like getting too much into this this speculation, let me just ask like a simple question, which is like the question that perhaps everyone will ask. And I'll ask like Jerry sir and Leslie, both of you this. A lot of people are getting this award. Achhi baat hai na? It will encourage young children to take up sport, right? हाँ ये अवार्ड हमें मिल सकता है. Isn't that like for giving so many people this award, these awards?
To an extent it is perhaps you are right, but on the other hand, so lot it might convince a lot of children to know that it is very easy to get the awards. I don't have to work much harder to get the award, because one, if 60 people are getting every year, And by God's grace, if it is increases to 80 or 100 in the next couple of years, then since there is a crowd, there is always a chance to get into it. I would say that previously people were unlucky. Perhaps people were unlucky because they realized that they had to work very hard to get this award. So world is getting easier. So perhaps getting awards is also getting easier for us.
So, like, just to like give it in terms of numbers, just talking in terms of numbers, Leslie, there's like the rules say that unless under exceptional circumstances, the rule says like 15 Arjuna awards and one Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna per year. Correct?
Yep.
Now, of course, the Rajiv Gandhi Khel, this is not the first time that more than one person will get the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna. A lot of times this has happened, especially in Olympic years when there have been multiple medalists, so they have been given Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna. But this is the first time there are five people who are going to be getting it. And in the Arjuna Award, similar situation where they're like, they say that you give 15, but in a year where there has been no Olympics, no Asian Games, 27 people are getting it. So how does, I mean, is this like, again, like at the cost of now sounding like I'm schizophrenic, I'm going to ask, like, isn't that diluting the award a bit? Leslie? To carry on with this point.
Yeah, just building on from Jadeep's point. The thing is, you get into sport and you get into any sport for that matter, Olympic, non-Olympic. We don't get into it because we can become a world champion easily or it's accessible. So most of the kids who start training, they know how tough it is to reach the pinnacle of the sport. And it's not the accessibility or the ease in which you can reach that stage that drives you, but certain other aspects. And so when you start your sporting career, and we all have interacted with a lot of sports persons who have spoken about their early part of their day careers and all that. Getting the Arjuna or getting any award for that matter is the least of the thing that could be motivating them to train every day, pack their bags and go 5 o'clock, reach the training venue. Afternoons you train, forsake your studies, forsake a lot of things to build towards where they are. So in that regard, the number of awardees this year is not going to be motivating any children towards a sporting career. But on the contrary, it might become a deterrent in bringing out the, it might bring down the stature of the awards in itself, because when we were coming up in sport, I mean, firstly as a competitor, when we were training also, there would be a lot of things, and I come from Kerala, so Kerala Sports Council used to organize a lot of interactive sessions with great athletes, former athletes, Olympians, Asian medalists, and all that, who would come and motivate us, give a talk to us. So introductory line would always be there when our coach or the manager of the camp or the hostel facility would say, Olympian XYZ and Arjuna Award on this year, and he will speak to us. And so Arjuna Award, it's huge in stature, so much so that a few years back, another very good friend of mine, M.R. Kuoma, who is part of the relay quartet still, she received the Arjuna Award. She was not there during the award ceremony because she was competing abroad. So she received the award separately from the sports ministry. And post that award, she came home with the trophy. She was just visiting me, and she also thought that it would be nice to show me the trophy, because she was, I mean, of course, elated. It's a high point in her career as well, because this is a big recognition for any athlete, this award. And to get it after winning at the Asian level, to get it, and it's a vindication of all the hard work that she has put, done so far to reach where she is, fighting injuries, fighting whatever adversaries that she has faced through the career. So he reached home, he showed me the award. I just couldn't bring myself to touch and carry that award. I mean, that much of respect. I mean, you look at the award and you know it's your award. It's I can't touch it. You keep it in a space. Let me admire it. And so that's the kind of respect that you have for the award. And then when these happen, when we as journalists we come across controversies each and every year when the awards are announced, when some people come and talk about favoritism or nepotism or things like that. Some people come and say that they deserved it, they didn't get it. Some people say that these guys don't deserve it. So a lot of blame game, mudslinging, everything happening. It's not just the number of awardees also, but the entire ecosystem of controversy that it brings. It's bringing down the stature of these awards to a state where even the athletes themselves would find it less of a.
So Jaideep sir, it's more of a tick mark. Leslie is a bit of a poet, but we are more like pragmatists, right? Like, I mean, देख लीजिए ना उनके उसके पीछे मेसी का पोस्टर लगा है. मेरे पीछे लगा हुआ it says lost zero. हमको नहीं मतलब है poet word से, हमारा number से मतलब है. So like honestly, like this is something that you were telling us rather just before we started recording, and the idea of this award, like Leslie is like very beautifully put it, like he understands the weight of that trophy, all the heart, the blood, sweat and tears that goes into getting it. But from the practical point of view, the Arjuna Award is more than just that trophy, right? Like there is like a lot of benefits that come with it. Like, do you mind like just telling us a little bit about it and like how much that matters in the award itself for an athlete? Just those benefits.
See, there are so many benefits. First, previously, one of the main benefits were free train tickets. You can always get it. There are benefits about getting your job at the government level, at the PSU level. There are benefits of being considered on priority basis on several issues. If a state government is forming a selection committee for selecting a team for a PSU or for anything else, whether it So they will like some experts to come into it. And there are fees involved in it. And the experts will be considered those who are Arjuna awardees, those who have been recognized by the government. So award carries lots of benefits carried. And at the same time, what Leslie said is also right. It carries huge prestige. Prestige and award is also has a reasonably good prize money. Of course, that is one time. But so, for the rest of the life, if you are an Arjuna, or if you are an Khel Ratna, if you are a Dhyan Chand, rest of the life, it gives you an advantage at many, many phases of the life. There is no doubt about it.
So see, like, so, again, like, history has proven that if poetry and prose are in like conflict, then mathematics will solve the question. Correct? So just like that, like in Arjuna Award, Khel Ratna, any national sports awards, there's mathematics, which is there is a point system to determine like who will win these awards. Right? Like now I have managed to pull out the point system and from what I've seen online. And it is on a 4-year cycle for the World Championships, World Cups, and the Olympics. For gold medal, it is 40 points, silver 30, bronze 20. For Asian Games, again on this cycle, for its gold medal is 30, silver 25, bronze 20. On a biannual or an annual cycle, it is the World Champs and the World Cups, for which you get gold 25, silvers 20, bronze 15. And the Commonwealth Games follows this last one's point system. Now, according to this, like what I see, like the one clear thing that I can see is this Asian Games and Commonwealth Games, there's a slight discrepancy in the point system. Correct? Like it's like the obvious one clear thing. If you have Asian Games mein athletics mein gold lange or Commonwealth Games mein athletics mein gold lange, so Commonwealth Games mein thoda kam aapko weightage diya jayega.
जबकि उल्टा होना चाहिए.
करेक्ट राइट यस करेक्ट
इन एथलेटिक्स
करेक्ट एब्सोल्युटली लाइक इन रेसलिंग फॉर एग्जांपल आई अज्यूम लेसली एशियन गोल्ड इज मच मोर वर्थ देन एट द कॉमनवेल्थ लेवल.
या वी विन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द गोल्ड मेडल्स एट द कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स व्हाइल इन एशियन गेम्स एट द मोस्ट वी हैव वन इज टू आई गेस इन वन गेम. अदरवाइज
बट इन एथलेटिक्स इन एशियन गेम्स वी डू रीजनेबली वेल.
वी डू रीजनेबली वेल.
वेल बट इवेंट्स इट इज आई थिंक फार मोर डिफिकल्ट टू डू इट इन द कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स एथलेटिक्स.
करेक्ट
इट्स इंपॉसिबल एक्चुअली. आफ्टर मिल्खा सिंह इट वाज नीरज हू
यस चोपड़ा वन अगेन. सो इट्स अ परफेक्ट. थैंक यू फॉर दैट सेग्वे. लेट्स
दिल्ली
थैंक यू फॉर दैट सेग्वे.
Delhi Commonwealth Games, we did reasonably good in athletics, I believe. We had some medals, right? In 2010 Commonwealth.
Yeah, I'm talking about gold medal.
We had gold medal in 2010 in athletics. No, I don't remember.
So, Neeraj, for example, like the best thing about Neeraj Chopra is that he's like, ki bas aap mathematics kariye, main javelin phek raha hun. So, he has won gold in Commonwealth as well as Asian Games. Correct? But he has not been considered for...
What I'm asking you, since you are doing the mathematics, you will be able to tell us better, which I don't know about. Somebody like Neeraj, as you were mentioning, let us take about Neeraj only. If Neeraj throws a world record, he makes a world record throw, which is accepted as a world record, and he after that he never gets a medal in Asian Games, Commonwealth Games, or in World Championship, where he will still be a world record holder, and where he will be in this point system, where he will find himself in this point system. That's why I'm asking.
Correct. So actually, this point system does not, like that the one that I have in front of me, does not account for Grand Prix and stuff like that, and that's where like the bigger problem like is. You've exposed a clear flaw, which is that it only considers Olympic disciplines in specific events, in specific festival events for those disciplines also. Like there are various disciplines that are also omitted from this point system entirely. Correct? Like cricket is outside of this point system, but cricket is outside of the purview of everyone except God, perhaps. Actually, they're also outside of the purview of God.
No, if tomorrow Sunil Chhetri, in a friendly match against France, 2018 world champions, scores a hat trick suddenly, so where do you put him? What's the point system says? Where does he figure in that calculation? That's why I'm asking.
So football, the awards. I mean, this year we have two awardees for football, right? Sanjay Jingan is there, and football's nominations are forwarded by AIF, I believe, and their criteria. I mean, it goes back to poetry, I guess, because I don't think we can justify it by SAF Games gold medal, right? Because SAF Games doesn't have points.
Correct.
So how do you justify it? So it's a different criteria altogether. So Sunil Chhetri or any player for that matter, it depends on what they have been doing in their careers, and then you get nominated, I guess. And so that creates a bit of a problem, which we will get to in the subsequently in this conversation, which I wanted to address and which I feel is very important.
Why don't you tell us like what the problem is, the inherent problem itself? Like, we can just get into it now. Only.
The inherent problem is the nomination process in itself.
Huh.
So, okay. What is happening is across the sport, the federation nominates athletes for these awards, except for this year when it was relaxed and self-nomination was allowed, which opened up a little bit of probably a dilemma for the committee members, because there were many who applied in an individual capacity, and someone like Shiva Keshavan, for instance, who deserved these awards around 10 years back when he won that Asian medal and when he was competing and representing India at the Winter Olympics, becoming a hero of sorts over there in the Winter Olympic cycle, but I mean, hardly recognized for all his achievements in India. So he applied and he received the award this year. So again, no criteria was followed here, because if the criteria was followed, then his performance was 10 years back. I mean, a few years back. So it can't be considered in that. It's not part of the 4-year cycle either. So, but the point is that he or someone like badminton player H.S. Pranoy, who directly applied again, and Pranoy has been vocal about the federation not forwarding his name for these awards because they have a problem with him. So this is what is happening with this nomination process. The people who come out, the athletes who have been forwarded for these awards are not, I mean, deserving or not, it's not the point here, but the ones who reach there are the ones who are on the good books with the federation, who are not rebel, who don't point out, who don't dissent. And these are points that we have discussed in NewsClick in previous episodes about when we talk about players and their voices and how important players are they to stand about. Especially now in this context, when in the US, entire professional sporting world has come to a sport in the stop in the US, protesting against violence against black people.
I think it's fair to say, Leslie, that like it's good that Naomi Osaka and LeBron James are not Indian, because they would not win the Arjuna Award.
They would never win. Going against the system, they would definitely never win.
I think it's fair to say that.
So the problem is here. So what is happening with this nomination system and slash the point system, which is more or less subjective, because when the committee forms, there are superseding powers, there are super vetoes that come into play, and certain players have been pushed for the award. It's that it helps in exerting a control over the players and their free will, and also on their right to express whatever is right or wrong in their particular field. We are not talking anyways about social issues or racism or anything here. If a national federation, if for instance Hockey India, we know that there are a lot of ills that happen in Hockey India. If a player stands up and points that
out. Sorry, Leslie, I have no idea what you're talking about. Nobody knows what the ills happen in Hockey India. If we knew.
So maybe we should ask the Khel Ratna from this year, Hockey's Khel Ratna, Rani Rampal, who, by the way, has been receiving all the awards that is out there to be received. And that I mean, she, of course, again, we are not questioning whether she deserves it or not. She is a
exactly like player. I've been trying to like veer away from like the reason I've been trying to veer away from naming athletes and questioning why they're getting the award is simply because, like, at a certain level, after a point, you realize it's not, why should an athlete like protest, like, or why are we criticizing the athlete in this case, right?
Exactly.
Like, because, I mean, again, like, this is like a nice segue into like two ladies who had applied, self-nominated themselves for the Arjuna Award. Both of them have received the Khel Ratna. They copped a lot of criticism also online, of course, for like seeking a lower award after having received the higher award. So again, like Jaideep sir has told us exactly the kind of like specific benefits that come with like winning the Arjuna Award. Jaideep sir, do these benefits also apply to the Khel Ratna, or what is the difference like between the Khel Ratna and the Arjuna? Is the Khel Ratna a higher award as people are constantly saying? Can you please give us a little bit?
I think it is definitely a higher award, because when you give giving some award 27 and some giving 5, then it must be the higher award. And correct. it has been almost a the name itself suggests it has been it was constituted as a parallel to Bharat Ratna in sport.
Now that you said it, sir, the name will be changed, but okay.
It's parallel to that. It seems. But the thing is that by logic, if you go by logic, then the benefits with Khel Ratna should be the same at every place, if not more. But if we go by what we read about what two of the sports persons who have already received Khel Ratna but also applied for Arjuna have to say that in their respective states they did not get the same benefits.
Correct.
Then it's a dilemma which none of us can solve actually, because it's a huge fault of the system, and that has to be and I think at least the sports ministry was right in denying these two sports persons the Arjuna Award. Because somebody who has got,
I also read about the issue that why these athletes, why these sports persons applied for Arjuna when they have already received a higher award. But I just don't understand what are the benefits that they seek, or what is the recognition or the windfall that they seek from the state government when we are talking about a award which is a central matter. This is a central sports ministry award, and the benefits come from for instance, the benefit you mentioned about pass for the railways. It's a central agency. Railway is a central organization, and that is regardless of which state you belong to and whatever the recognition or lack of recognition that is there. You get all these benefits, right? So, what are they missing out on?
State government jobs, perhaps. I think state government jobs have some specific... I think so. That's what I have been given the impression. I have not seen there what they do. But I think when a state government puts out an advertisement for recruiting certain number of sports persons in a particular discipline, their advertisement simply says those who have won Arjuna, received Arjuna, should apply.
The thing is, if an Olympic medalist, which is Akshay Malik, and if a world champion, which is Mirabai Chanu, apply for a job, who would say that you guys have not received Arjuna Award, so we are not giving you a job?
That's the reason perhaps they have been denied.
Yeah.
But it's been their logic.
That episode itself shows the absurdity in our... I mean, sir, yeah, so we shouldn't be blaming athletes for saying that we deserve the award or we deserve the award, we need it, or there has been foul play or anything like that. But we definitely can't help but criticize them for the kind of attitude that you're bringing onto the table, and it definitely brings down the stature of the Olympic medal that she has won or the world championship, because you are fighting for the wrong reason here. You've gotten a higher award from the country, and you better fight to be in that national team. I'm talking about Sakshi Malik over here. She lost in the national trials recently, so she better be worried about her form and going into the upcoming season and possibly try and make it to the Olympics to defend her medal or change the color of her medal. But that's not the priority, it seems. It seems you fight for awards more than you fight for medals, which is what your job should be.
Okay.
What Leslie says is right, but I have a feeling those who are in the right in the middle of the thing, on the pitch, on the field, they realize it more. Perhaps if you ask one of those two sportspersons that why did you do it, they might give you instance by instance when in a particular place the Arjuna Award was given more preference to the Khel Ratna because of some old rule which has not been changed by some officers in that particular department or in that area. So there is some anomaly must be there. So it should be threshed out. What Leslie says is right. Ideally, they should, after winning world championship and winning an Olympic bronze medal, they should be more worried about their own form than anything else, than awards. After receiving the country's highest awards also.
It's not like they were deprived. So if it was Neeraj Chopra who was complaining, because Vaibhav was getting into that point earlier, he has not received Arjuna.
No, he has gotten a... He's got an Arjuna Award. He's not got a Khel Ratna.
So, ideally, he should have gotten it earlier because 2018 was a landmark year for him. He won both the Continental Championship and the unprecedented feat of winning at the Commonwealth Games, which is a much tougher competition in athletics. So, why did it not happen? Maybe the federation didn't nominate him, so that creates the position.
Is
Chopra worried about it? That's the problem. Has Chopra come out and said that I deserved it that year? Why wasn't hockey? He doesn't care because he has a larger goal in his mind. He knows that he is there. And anything short of an Olympic medal, that's what he has been continuously saying. Anything short of an Olympic medal is a failure for him. And so So he is working towards that and he's not least bothered about getting into all these discussions and getting unnecessary attention.
So let's just forget, Neeraj Chopra is like a very talented athlete who will like win a lot of things. I'm not even going to say if all holds to form is that, because I'm being really hopeful here. He will do a lot of great things for India. And of course, sure, like he's at some point of time, he will win this hugest laurel that this country has to offer sportspersons. But like I'm talking about like, say, someone like Arpinder Singh, who won a gold at the Asian Games in triple jump. He has not even won the Arjuna Award. Let's forget about everything else. His coach received the Dronacharya for Arpinder winning gold in triple jump last year. Okay, but the athlete has been ignored. Now, I understand that coaches are really important and they duly, both of them should be lauded, applauded and awarded. Poetry.
I think that is one great flaw in it. Perhaps another person from the same discipline has got it.
Yes.
That makes the difference.
People are getting it
because there is nobody around. So let's give it to. But look, if you look at it, you are diluting things for the sake of it, that you have to give it. In the first 1961 list of Arjuna Award is, in tennis, Ramanathan Krishnan got it. He reached the Wimbledon semi-final that year. So, but if you come down to now, I'm not naming anyone. If you just manage to get into first 128 in Wimbledon, that's the main draw, then you might land up getting it. Just because you don't have anyone around, that's the reason. So should it be like that one federation has recommended you? The federation has, of course, will recommend. Their boy or their girl, they will recommend. That is their job. Very nice of them also. So you have to give someone from that particular discipline. Does that mean you have to give someone who has not really done much? And if in one discipline, like you said, in some disciplines, 3-4 people have done well. And okay, give it to him this year and next year we'll give it to. So how this policy, is it right or it should be balanced to an extent? That's why I'm asking.
So actually what you're saying about this federation.
What I mean to say is the worst part of the entire thing is the dilution of award. The award should be, the standard should be exacting. And if somebody doesn't meet it, then thank you very much. You try and we'll see what to be done next year. But that nobody is reaching the standard, you are bringing down your award. That will not do any justice to even people who have rightly received it.
So there's one, like when you're talking about this federation thing, it brings up a very interesting point, because in the selection committee, there is Deepa Malik was part of the selection committee. Okay, she's a former Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna. She's the first Indian para athlete to have won a medal at the Olympics, at the Paralympics. Okay, she's a great, like in every regard of the word, she's done a lot for the sport. She was part of the selection committee while holding the post of the head of the Paralympic Committee of India. Now, of course, Paralympic Committee of India is not yet recognized as an NSF. All right. But there is like an obvious conflict of interest in that there is a member of the committee who is also the head of this federation. So, and it has led to a situation where a lot of para athletes are winning the awards. Correct?
Yeah, but she has been elected as what? And in what capacity she has been selected? As a medal winner?
Yes, as a medal winner. As a former great athlete.
Then correct. BCCI should send Sourabh Ganguly as the member of the Arjuna committee, isn't it? He's apart from being BCCI president, he's former India captain also. And I think he scored.
Now that you have said it, and if Jay Shah is watching us, then yeah, next year count on that.
So if that is so, then Sahadev was a good weightlifter, I believe, in his younger days. He should be there. So I can name lot of federation bosses who has done reasonably well during their sporting days also, isn't it? So in that case, if that is the criteria, then it is very dangerous.
Now, I'll be honest with you. I'll be honest with both of you. Like, I'm very conflicted about like a lot of these para athletes being awarded these awards. Okay, like conflicted in the sense that it's really great because these men and women rarely get recognition in whatever sports they take part in this country. We as a country don't like respect athletes with special abilities at all. On the other hand, I also find that a lot of other athletes with special abilities have been completely ignored, right? Like deaf athletes, blind athletes, Special Olympians. They've all been completely ignored out of this list. So that is one huge conflict, which perhaps then provokes the question, like, is there like a need to like perhaps also separate these athletes and give them create a separate award for them, because their achievements should not be like equated at all with able-bodied athletes. There's no reason. Like, I mean, I personally believe their achievements are bigger. The strife, the blood and sweat and tears they put in is much bigger than anyone else. So is it like, I don't know, Leslie, like you can perhaps like help me out with this, like help everyone who's watching also like resolve this if you have this conflict. Like, am I asking for something outlandish? Am I saying something wrong?
No, you know, it's not. The idea of stature comes here. So you answered the question yourself when you said that we as a country don't respect the achievement of these athletes. So what makes you think that a newly constituted award just for special athletes would give them recognition? The award won't even be considered so as an achievement in itself. The what Arjuna stands for me, if you ask me, or the National Sports Awards, any of those awards, is an integration. Is where every athlete of various disciplines come on a platform where everyone is recognized on an equal footing for the achievement that they have done for the country in competitions abroad. And in that regard, the para-athletes are equal in their qualification for these awards, and they should be part of these awards as well. Yeah, being as far as the number of the scope for the numbers expansion, involved in these awards, there is always a limit to how many athletes can be included in it. Yeah, of course, certain athletes, deserving athletes, para athletes would miss out on that. Just like normal athletes are missing out as well. And but it also has come out that compared to the other disciplines, where an athlete, if he or she misses out, they at least have some kind of voice to shout it out as well, which comes out in the media. It doesn't come out much for the para athletes. Their voice is never heard.
Correct.
And And so Deepa Malik's position in that committee was with the premise that the voices of these para-athletes would be heard over there. Now, within the scope of her work, now you mentioned when you started off saying that she has done a lot for the sport. She has done a lot for the sport as an athlete, perhaps, yes. But as an administrator, that's questionable. So, and it's very clear in her role in this committee as well. So, that's unfair because being a para-athlete and understanding what it takes to be there, be a para-sports person, fighting day-to-day existential adversities as well as system and sustenance and all the other factors that across disciplines athletes face, along with that, the additional challenges that these athletes face. Knowing all that and then being unfair to a bunch of them, that's unpardonable. But that's how it is. That's how unfortunate the scenario is. So the point here is, how do we negate that? Now that we have more or less established the idea that there are certain flaws in the system. So how do we revamp that? I think like just like every institution or every sport or any endeavor for that matter, there is always a evolutionary process that happens to match with the times, to change when things are shown that things are not right or things are not working. So that kind of a system revamp is due, I guess, and that's where things are heading to, and possibly this year would be considered as a turning point towards, I mean, as a turning Normal. Point which triggered that kind of a move towards making things a bit more objective and foolproof.
See, the thing is, like, I don't believe that, like, separating them is, like, necessarily can only be viewed as a from the lens of, like, hey, it's not nice to separate them. This reward as a legacy, a new reward may not. Like Jay said, if I'm not mistaken, again, adventure sports has its own category of award. Correct?
Yeah, but
the National Sports Awards.
National Sports Awards. But
and what happens is, if you separate something, then there is more umbrella, maybe? Is that like something? Is that...
Because I thought, not because of anything else, because since it is about Olympic sport, and Olympic and Paralympics are played separately. They are never not played together. Asian Games and Para-Asian Games is not played together. No? So, let's there be, it's not, see, just because you are, if you separate someone from Arjuna Awards, doesn't mean it's a negative. Why should anyone take it as a negative idea? It could be a positive idea also, that create a special Khel Ratna, Arjuna, or Dhyanchand, or Dronacharya, and what all we have for entire thing for the Paralympics. So there will be, again, if you are giving it 60, that means you have numbers in mind. So it will be more, the merrier it will be, I can say, in that case. So I don't think separating means that you are trying to negate somebody, or it's, no negative effect should come in mind on this, I think. It would be a good, bad idea. Because Olympics and Paralympics are not played together. They have competed separately, isn't it? The benchmark is different. So let there be awards also different. What is wrong in it? The more people will get it.
Leslie, you were saying something?
No, I understand the argument that more the merrier argument. But is that what we want as a society, or we want
inclusion.
Para-athletes to feel that they are also part of a sporting system and they are not treated as some additional entity which requires a special category for to be recognized, and they also see it's also a very, very subjective point, but they also will leave with a feeling that we are different, we are probably not at the same. I mean, it's clear that feeling would remain, and so we as media persons can also, I mean, think about it. So when we are covering the Arjuna Award plus the Special Arjuna Award, which goes as lead? And will we even mark it as a subheader? When we have worked in newspapers, so we have the entire list going on Niche, and then the what it goes is Arjuna list will come, Khel Ratna list will come and possibly Dronacharya and delete the rest because there is no space in that column.
Correct.
These are all realities.
Like, of course, it is my tendency to cheapen a very nice argument with like a slightly silly joke. So do you think it'll help if they name it the Bheem Award?
But I think they can make a rule that at least one or at least two don't make a rule about Khel Ratna, but Arjuna and rest of the award, they can make a rule that two Arjuna awards has to go to Paraflicks.
Right now there's one.
At least two or three must go. Even Dronacharya must go and Dhyanchand also go. Except Khel Ratna shouldn't be allowed to go diluted in any form, I think. Khel Ratna.
Correct.
And also we are talking with the idea that I understand the recognition and what it brings on to the for these athletes at all. But then any athlete, any awards across the world for that matter, not everybody can get it. I mean, it's just for instance, if you look at if you look in a sporting idea of victory, and if you happen to be in the same era as Usain Bolt running 100 meters, no matter how good you are, you end up getting a silver or a bronze. You run for silver or a bronze. And it's unfortunate because you have a great athlete whom you rub shoulders with. The same thing applies to an award in literature. Maybe Man Booker, if you look at it. In a given year, if you have five great authors and their work, and if one person is picked, that doesn't, kill the entire purpose of existence of the other four writers, right? You write for a different reason altogether. You don't write for so that one day you get this award. So the same thing, athletes run their races for whatever the reason is. It may be to get a government job. It can be to win an Olympic medal, but that reason remains. And it award is definitely a boost. It's definitely a recognition, but that's not the end of it all. So that's the point. So when we talk about athletes missing out because only limited numbers are there, athletes are missing out in a regular award as well, among regular athletes as well. But athletes missing out because there is politics at play, athletes missing out because there is subjectivity in the rules or subjectivity in the selection procedure, or athletes missing out just because their names were not pushed in. These are unpardonable. So that's where we should be getting at, where such things are ironed out from the system altogether. How do we do that? That's a more pertinent question that we should ask ourselves as sports journalists, and then at a larger plane we should bring it out so that everybody.
So actually, that's like a great note. That's a great note to like sort of conclude this chat on, which is, I mean, also if you're watching this, like, do let us know what you think. Because essentially, at any point of time, we are not arguing for the award system to be scrapped. We are not like criticizing the athletes who are getting them. What we are questioning is the system itself for this, the selection system, the award system, the governance system, the application system of these awards, which were constituted so far back that the world we live in today does not resemble that world at all. Like, for example, in front of me, I have the first two winners of the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna. I just want to leave like everyone with this. The first two winners of the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna was in 1991, Vishwanathan Anand for chess, and in 1992-93, Geet Sethi for billiards. Two men who perhaps won't even be from two sports that are not even considered among the cream of the crop in Indian swan section. Thank you.